Hello and welcome to my channel. The structured metal title animation is what we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video. Please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. I have imported some stock image files and stock video files. Create a new composition. I am choosing a 1920x1080 composition with the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 8 seconds. Bring in the background image file and scale it up to fit the composition. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in subscribe, centerline the text. Bring in the texture image file into the composition and place it below the text layer. Scale it to the size of the text layer. Set the track mat of the texture image file to alpha text layer. Search for curves effect from the effects panel and apply it into the texture layer. Create a S curve for more contrast. Apply the curves effect to the background image also and increase the contrast. Search for tint effect and apply it into the background layer. Select the text layer and the texture image file and right click and click on Precompose. Name the Precompose as Textured Text and click OK. Open the Textured Text layer and turn on the visibility of the text layer. Search for Gradient Wipe effect and apply it into the text layer. Set the gradient layer to texture. Set the transition completion to around 50% and the transition softness to around 30%. And set the track matte to Luma Matte text layer. Go to the main composition and right click on the textured text composition and go to layer styles and click on bevel and emboss. Go to the textured text layer, change the completion and softness values in the gradient wipe effect and set the transition completion to around 40. Set the softness to around 12%. Go to the main composition and duplicate the textured text layer. Search for bevel alpha effect and apply it into the duplicated layer. Set the edge thickness to 5. And change the color as you wish. Rename the duplicated text layer to Bevel Textured Text. Search for Drop Shadow effect from the Effects and Presets panel and apply it into the Bevel Textured Text layer. Set the distance to around 20 and the softness to around 50. Set the opacity to 100% and duplicate the textured layer once more. Search for fill effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the duplicated layer. Move the fill effect above the drop shadow effect and change the color to black. Bring down the topmost text layer just above the background layer. Select all the textured text layers and right click and click on precompose. Name it as text. Search for tint effect and apply it into the text composition. Change the color as you wish. Since I am going to create the gold color text, I am choosing a light orange color. Change the layers to 3D layers. Create a new camera. Also create a new null object and make the null object as 3D layer. Parent the camera to the null one layer. Bring up the position property of the null one layer and at the 15 frame mark, create a keyframe and go to the start of the timeline and increase the Z value to zoom in the text layer. Now RAM preview this. The animation is too slow for me, so I am bringing in closer the keyframes. Yeah, that would be good. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Maybe two more frames. I am bringing in the keyframes much more closer. Now RAM preview this, yeah that's good. Turn on the motion blur of the text layer. Bring in the smoke hit footage file into the timeline and place it below the camera layer. Set the blending mode to add. Scale it up to match the animation. We don't want the sparks, so I am trimming up the sparks portion. Place the smoke at the very place where the text hits the background. Press T to bring up the opacity property and at the 7 frame mark create a keyframe for opacity and at the start of the footage set the opacity value to 0%. Now select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Ramp preview this. Oh, that's looking good. Apply the tint effect to the smoke footage and change the color to that of the text layer. The color is too dark, so I am increasing the brightness. Yes, that is good. Open up the text composition and bring in the reflection map image file into the timeline. Scale down the image file to that of the text layer. Search for motion tile effect and apply it into the reflection map. Increase the output width and output height very high. Click on the mirror adjust checkbox. Select all the layers except the reflection map layer and right click and click on pre-compose. Name it as pretext and click OK. Select the reflection map layer and create a keyframe for tile center at the end of the timeline. Go to the start of the timeline. Decrease the tile center value to around -1500. Pre-compose the reflection map image file and make sure you click on move all attributes. Change the track mat of the reflection map composition to alpha mat pretext layer. Now search for CC glass effect and apply it into the reflection map layer, and also apply the CC blobless effect to the reflection map layer. These are the final settings for the CC glass and CC blobless effects. As I have wasted to around 20 to 30 minutes in searching a good combination of their values, I am skipping that part. Go to the main composition and bring in the lens flare file into the timeline and place it below the camera layer. Set the blending mode to add. Go to the text layer, copy the tint effect and paste it into the lens flare footage. Offset the lens flare file to where the text hits the background layer. Create a keyframe for opacity property at the 17 frame mark and go to the start of the flare file and set the opacity value to 0%. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. The lens flare file does not match with the animation, so I'm moving it near the start of the timeline. Yeah, that would be good. Go to the text layer and select the reflection map layer and move the tile center from the 3 second mark to around 6 frame mark. From the project panel, bring in the particles footage file into the main composition timeline. Search for curves effect and apply it into the particles footage. Change the curves as shown. Set the blending mode to add. Copy the tint effect from the text composition and paste it into the particles footage file. Select the background layer and go to the curves effect and change the curves as you wish to bring in your desired look. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's it. Let's see the output once again. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.